Hearty congratulations to all my dear colleagues in the Department of Archaeology, Government of Sri Lanka. I learned that 7th July marks the National Archaeology Day there, and the celebrations have been planned for more than 2 weeks or so, and series of programs are going to be an exciting opportunity to celebrate the archaeology of Sri Lanka and so on. At this point of time, I'm very, very happy to congratulate the administration, including the present Director General. And I must also mention at this point that I have met several of my Sri Lankan archaeology colleagues since the time of my post-graduation at Deccan College way back in 1972. Since then, I have been meeting a lot of these Sri Lankan archaeologists who were coming to Deccan College for post-graduation, and then of course some of them continued for their PhD and then went back, and they are all well placed today in different universities and also in the Central Department of Archaeology, and which is as old as the Archaeological Survey of India. It may be younger by 5 or 6 years or so, but yet the history of this particular department is very, very long. And during the course of these 150 years or more, Sri Lankan Archaeology Department has achieved great landmarks in terms of investigations into early historic archaeology, and then Holocene archaeology, and as well as late Pleistocene archaeology, and so on. And I heard of the senior Dr. P.E.P. Dharaniyakala when I was a postgraduate student at Deccan College, because Professor Sankalia and several other senior teachers used to refer to his work Balagonda site, which was excavated by him, and also his publications were also referred to us. But later on, I happened to meet Professor or Dr. Siran Dharaniyakala during the conference in Indonesia. And since then, I was very keenly following the prehistoric archaeological research in Sri Lanka, and have been very keenly going through the publications of Dr. Siran Dharaniyakala, Nimal Pereira, and also early historic archaeological research carried out by the Kelaniya University, and also many foreign institutions working in Sri Lanka were always keeping us well informed about the exciting developments in different areas of archaeology of Sri Lanka and so on. And I was so keen on visiting some of the sites, especially prehistoric sites in Sri Lankan highlands, the famous caves of Batadamba Lena, Fahian Lena, and Bailey Lena, Kitulgala, and wanting to visit them because long before the peninsular India could think of dating the antiquity of microliths to 40 to 40,000 years, or dating them to the later Pleistocene, Sri Lanka had produced excellent results with respect to these microlithic sites, cave occupations, and also human remains. And Sri Lanka had occupied a very prominent place in global prehistory because of the high antiquity of the microliths there, as well as the human remains that were recovered. Unlike in the Indian subcontinent, where we do not have Pleistocene context human remains, reported from a number of sites. We may have one or two examples, but only in the recent past we have been able to identify the preservation of human remains, but very, very small in number. And also we are also successful in the recent past, in the last 10 to 15 years, that even in India we have microliths going back to late Pleistocene, are now going back up to 50,000 years or so. The only site that was known in the Indian context where microliths were dated to about 28 to 30,000 years was Patne. But the Sri Lankan sites were very well dated. And recent publications coming from younger generation of archaeologists in Sri Lanka were also very stimulating and inspiring. Many archaeologists working on the later Pleistocene sites in India. And the date of Batadamba Lena site now extending back to 50,000 years, and similar sites, open-air microlithic sites in central India dating back to 50,000 years ago, also make a lot of sense, because there are a lot of prehistoric connections between India and Sri Lanka. And I was very, very keen on visiting some of these sites, and this was made possible through my colleagues in Sri Lanka, especially Dr. Anura Manathunga, who facilitated communication with several other archaeologists whom I had lost contact because of, not being able to maintain, continuous communication with them. But this helped me. And then we visited some of these caves. We also had detailed interaction and discussion with Siran Dhiraniyagala, and also participated in a seminar at Kelaniya University. And then because of the facilitation provided by the Department of Archaeology, we were able to visit many early historic sites and so on. And I'm so happy that this event is taking place very soon. And then I have great pleasure in extending my greetings, and I congratulate the Department of Archaeology for all its achievements. And I'm sure the intensity of archaeological research that is going on in Sri Lanka will certainly place the archaeology of Sri Lanka in the forefront of global prehistoric research. All the best to all my colleagues in the Department of Archaeology, Sri Lanka government. Thank you.